Hello everyone, welcome to Neerja Education. This is class 8, science, lesson number 2, microorganisms, friend or foe. So before getting to the chapter, I want to give the brief introduction about the microorganisms. Microscopic organism, commonly known as microbes, microorganism. They are found all around the world, even inside or outside the body also it is present. The category of the microbes include massive range of an organism including bacteria, virus, algae, fungi, protozoa, etc. The vast majority of the microbes on the earth pose no real threat to human, plants and animals. In fact, they actually work along side to human to make the world go around, aiding decomposition, decay and even helping us to digest our food. So it helps us to be a friend, it acts as a friend. At the same time, all the microorganism is not act as a friend, some of them become a foe. Foe means enemies. However, there are some microorganisms which negatively impact our lives, causing illness, damaging products, damaging buildings and outer surface. Some names are we are regularly hear in the media, like Salmonella, causing typhoid fever, dengue, malaria. Adequately nowadays we are hearing about one deadly disease that is called Corona. It caused by a virus COVID-19. It scares the entire world because total population is diminishing. So, in this chapter, we will briefly explain some major division of microorganism and hopefully highlight some interesting facts and differences within this group. Right? So now get into the chapter. What is mean by microorganism? The microorganism we can also called microbes. So microbes or microorganism is a small living organism which we can't see our naked eye. Direct eye we can't see. Majority of the microorganism we can't see our naked eye. But certain microorganism we can see our naked eye, like mushroom, spirogyra, algae, yeast. These all are some exceptional cases we can see our naked eye. But majority of the microorganism we can't see our naked eye. We need one tool to see. That instrument is called either magnification lens or the instrument is called microscope. So with the help of microscope, under the microscope we can see those microorganisms. The microscope was discovered by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. He is the first person discovered simple microscope. At the same time, he is the first person identify or discovered microbes in rainwater. So he is the first person discovered simple microscope. At the same time, he was discovered first microbes in rainwater also. Study of microbes or microorganism, that branch of science is called microbiology. You may hear science are different branches like botany, zoology, biochemistry, biotechnology, microbiology. So the microbiology means study of microorganism. So those who are studying, the scientist called as microbiologist. I hope you have understood. Study of microorganism is called microbiology. One who study, the scientist, one who research about the microbes, those scientists are called microbiologist. Next, we are going to discuss habitats of microorganisms. The microorganisms are found all kind of environment. They present everywhere. So we can tell as omnipotent. Omnipotent or omnipresent. What is mean by omnipotent or omnipresent means they can live any kind of environment. They found in air, soil of various types including desert, marshy soil, water including hot spring, river, lakes, seawater, pond, etc. They can live even dead and decaying matter also. Many microorganisms, they can live inside or outside the body of human being, plants as well as animals. So that is the reason we are telling microorganisms are omnipotent or also called omnipresent. So this is the habitat of microorganism. Once again I repeat, microorganism present everywhere like air, water, soil. Soil, all kind of soil it can live. Desert soil, marshy soil, or any kind of soil. At the same time, all water bodies they can live, like hot spring, cold water, salt water, or pond, river, different kind of fresh water also they can live. Even they can live in a dead and decaying matter also, they can present inside or outside the living organism also. So that we are telling microorganisms are called omnipotent or omnipresent. Next, we are going to discuss the major groups of microorganism. The microorganisms are classified into 5 types. Majorly, it is classified into 5 types. The first one is bacteria. Second is fungi. Third, algae. Fourth one is protozoans. Fifth one is viruses. These all are 5 different types of microorganisms. Bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoans or protozoan and viruses. This is singular. These all are called plural form. Singular form, if you know that bacteria singularly we can say bacterium. Fungi singular, fungus. Algae singular, alga. Protozoan, protozoan. Or plural we can tell protozoan or protozoa. Viruses, virus. So these are the 5 major types of microorganism. This is very, very important. We have to learn each and everything in detail. First we will discuss about bacteria. Before studying bacteria, you just see the habitats where the microorganisms are present. See, they are present everywhere. Pond, marshy land, desert, everywhere, even the plant, animal body, dead and decaying matter also, it is present. You look at the picture, you get an idea. Next, already we discussed major type of microorganism, bacteria, virus, fungi, algae, protozoa. First, we are going to study in detail bacteria. Bacteria singular, bacterium. It is abundant of simplest living organism. Among 5, the bacteria is an abundant one. They have different varieties. So, at the same time, the simplest of all living organism. The body structure is very, very simple. Right? Next, we are going to discuss about habitat of bacteria. The bacteria is living everywhere. As we all know that microorganisms are omnipotent. They can present everywhere. So the bacteria also present everywhere like air, water, soil, food, etc. Next we are going to learn about size. The size may be vary. Some of the bacteria are very, very minute. We have to see under microscope. Some of them we can see naked eye, but most probably majority 99% we can see under the microscope. But the size may be different. So the size 0.2 to 100 micrometer in diameter. So 1 micron equal to 1/1000 millimeter. So that much minute it is. So the range is 0.2 to 100 micrometer in diameter. Smallest bacteria is called mycoplasma. What do you call? Mycoplasma is a smallest bacteria. Mycoplasma. Next, shapes. You look at the picture, you will see different 4 different types of bacteria. One is cocci. You see, this is the one, the circular spherical like structure, that is called cocci. So singular we can tell coccus. One small structure is called staphylococcus. The second one is called bacilli, bacillus. Singular is called bacillus, plural we can tell is bacilli. First one is cocci, singular we can tell coccus. Coccus means round or spherical shape. The second one is bacilli, singular we can tell bacillus. It's a rod shape. You look at the picture. Then third one is spirilla, singular we can tell spirillum. It is a spiral shape. Then the fourth one, it is called Vibrio. Vibrio means comma shaped bacteria. You just see that picture, you get an idea. There are the four different types of, different shapes of bacteria are there. Cocci, bacilli, spirilla, as well as Vibrio. Four major shapes of bacteria. Now we have to study in detail. Different shapes of bacteria. As we all know that the bacteria, according to the shapes, it classified into four types: cocci, bacilli, spirilla, as well as Vibrio. So cocci is nothing but a small round or spherical shape structure. The cocci are different. This, some of the cocci are present one single. So this single is called monococci. Some of the cocci are present double. It look like a 8 shape structure, 8 number. So those cocci are called diplococci. Diplo means 2. Some of the cocci are arranged in a chain like appearance. That chain like appearance is called a stepto. Stepto means chain. Chain cocci, streptococci. Some of them are look like a bunch of grapes or bunch like appearance. Those cocci are called staphylococci. These are the different categories of cocci. Some of them live single, that is called monococci. Some of them are joined together, two cocci are joined together, that is called diplococci. It look like a egg shaped structure. Some of them are make a chain like structure, that is called stepto. Some of them are making bunch like structure, that is called staphylo. This is the bacilli. Bacilli means it is a rod shaped structure. Already we saw the image also. Some of the rod shapes are look like a spoon like structure. This is the type of bacilli only, that is called Clostridium. This Clostridium bacteria, you just keep it in your mind. We will discuss the harmful effect of bacteria. That time you will get an idea. That is called Clostridium. Then spiral shape and comma shape, we already saw in images. Some of the bacteria are present in the absence of oxygen, that is called anaerobic bacteria. Anaerobic bacteria means the bacteria without oxygen, they can live. Those bacteria are called anaerobic bacteria. Another one category is called aerobic bacteria. They can live in oxygen condition. So they need oxygen to live. Those bacteria are called aerobic bacteria. I hope you have understood bacteria and its shapes. At the same time, please subscribe our channel Nirja Education. Don't forget to press the bell icon as well as like button also. Thank you. Have a nice day.